वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंदसहोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्त बृंदावन मनोहर वाचाकूश कृपा सिंधुवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्किपातमहं वंदे परमानन्दमाधवं वृंदावि तुलसीदेव वैपियावि केशवस्य कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयि नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवी सरस्वती व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण धैयं सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदं शिव विरिञ्चिनुतं शरण्यं भीतात्तिहं पुनदपालभवद्विपूतं वन्दे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजितकिमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरससागरसारमूर्तिः साराधिकामयि कदा कृपा श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनका वदातु संकेतनैकवितरो कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वन्दे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणाभतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पादपंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितोदीपरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापम् गौरी निरंतर विभूषितवाम भागम नारायण प्रियमनंग मदापहारम वाराणसीपुरपति भज वीशनाथम बागीशाजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि जस्यास्ते हृदय संवित् त्वं निशिंगमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे बहवो पदं प्राप्ता त्रष्टा कया दवादयो विषपरवावलिर्वाणमयश्चाथ विभीषणः सुग्रीवो हनुमान ऋक्षो गजो गृद्धो वनिकोपतः व्याधः कुब्जा व्रजे गुप्तो यज्ञः पत्नस्तथापरि तेनाधितो सुतिगणानोपासितो महत्तमः अव्रतात्तप्त तपसः सत्संग्यात्मानुपागतः बहवो मत्पदं प्राप्ता त्रष्टोकयाधवादयो विषपर्वावलिर्वलिर्वाणोमयश्चाथो विभीषणः सुग्रीवो हनुमान ऋक्षो गजो गृद्धो वनिकोपतः व्याधः कुब्जा व्रजे गोप्पो यज्ञपत्नस्तथापरि तेनाधीत सुतिगणा नोपासितो महत्तमः अव्रतात्तप्त तपसो सत्संग्यात्मानुपागतः गौरी गोष्ठीपति श्रीशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु रिक्वेस्टिंग टू एवरीबॉडी जगद्गुरु प्रभुपाद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर रिक्वेस्टिंग एवरीबॉडी that for the time being, you please stop and lend your submissive and regardful ear to me. You give your attention and your ear to me, so that I can allow Harikatha to go inside your heart. Prabhupada requesting to everybody, for the time being, you stop material discussion, material thinking, and please lend your submissive and regardful ear to me. All different kind of material conception and talkings, you please keep stop for some time, and please try to give your oral reception, hearing organ to me. I like to speak transcendental sound. I am in favor of transcendental sound vibration. I am in favor of satsanga because I know it for sure. Satsanga can never go in vain. Provided I am niskapat, there is no duplicity inside me. Sincerity is there, no duplicity. In that case, I am in favor of transcendental sound. I know all rubbish things going to acquire all your heart and brain, all rubbish things, material things, all going to, you know, acquire your all your heart and brain. You are going to collect all material things which has no connection with Krishna Seva, Krishna Bhajan. In this way, if you like to do Hari Bhajan or Raganuga Bhajan, it's one kind of gossip. He's joking. With this head, with his heart, you cannot even 1 inch, you cannot progress in the way of Brajadham. With this dirty brain and dirty heart, you cannot proceed even 1 inch towards Brajadham. What to speak about Raganuga Bhajan? Baba speaking, those foreign devotees, those who have no idea about Radha Govinda, we are going to publish it directly. You can read it. If at least birth after birth, if they can at least understand Lakshmi Narayan or at least Sita Ram, Ram Sita, that is also a big achievement for them. They will have to wait thousands of birth to understand actually the glories of Radharani. For everybody it is applicable, not that, you know, specially Prabhupada requesting everybody, please try to follow the rules and regulation properly. Those who can demand as a giant intellect, those who are very famous in the world, don't try to hear them at present. If I seek the path leading to the absolute good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul. Prabhupada speaking, those who can desert as giant intellect in this material world, they are established in the society. Please don't hear them. You stop their hearing. Try to hear transcendental sound from the actual source of that sound. I mean, proper Hari Guru Vaishnava. You will have to hear. Empirism must not be medium. Bhajan is not a matter of suggestive matter. Bhajan is not, people think, suggestive matter. Not that. If I can try bhajan, if it is okay, okay, if not okay, not okay, like lottery. Prabhupada saying, idiot people, foolish. It is not like that, like lottery. I am trying, okay, okay, if not okay. It's not like lottery. It is not that type of objective. The bhakti can directly identify you, the actual object of your bhajan. Direct bhakti can identify you directly, that absolute truth. You need not play your head. Only you will have to get simplicity, complicacy you should kick out of your heart, and at the same time sincerity should be there and no duplicity. And surely by the help of Guru Vaishnav Satsanga and Guru Vaishnav, you can reach your goals. To follow pure Guru Vaishnav under their, to stay under their guidance, under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnav is called actually bhakti. Bhakti is not auto-suggestive matter. You can follow, you cannot follow. If Gurudev speaking this, okay, this I cannot accept. If my desire going to match with my Guru Maharaj's desire, then I can follow, give respect. Otherwise, who is going to pay respect to him? He is not Vaishnava, he is not sadhu. I am sadhu. Because I know how to measure a Guru Vaishnava. That I know very well. The sloka I started with is very important. You know, you maybe you have heard many times before. Bahobo matpadam prapta trashto kaya dhavadayu vishaparava valirvana mayascha thobivishana shugriva hanuman miksho gajo griddho vaniko patho vyadha kubja braje gopo Yagyo patnos tathapare tena adita satigana nopasito mahattamaha abrata tapta tapaso satsangyat mam pagataha. Very important. You know, Bahubo Bhagavan speaking himself in 11th canto to Uddhava. Many such, you know, devotees reach me. Trashto Kayadhabadaya Kayadhabamane Prahlad Maharaj, you know, Vrittasur, Trashto Kayadhabadaya Vishwaparva, you know, Vishwaparva Maharaj, Bali, Ban, Mayo, Mayascha Atha Vibhishanaha, Sugriv, Hanuman, Nrikho, Jambuvan, Nrikho, Gajo, I mean Gajendra, you know, they all, you know, Griddha, Vanika, Patha, you know, and Vyad also, Kubja, Braje Gopo, Bajagopikas, Jagapatni, those who are the wives of the Jagyik Brahman, they all reach me simply by the help of Satsanga. But you have no faith in Satsanga 100%. At all, if you have some faith, okay, if Maharaj is going to speak according to my desire, then okay, otherwise I can reject Maharaj. This is your standard of, you know, feeling. This is your faith in Guru Vaishnava. Tena adhita suti ganaha, they never read Shruti, Siti, Puran. They never read. Na adhita suti ganaha. They were never read Ved, Vedanta, etc. No pasita mahatamaha, any mahat bhakti. Motir nakishne parato shatova. Mitho vipadde tu griho vratanam. Or you see, another slogan you know, Naishang mati stava duru kramanthi, prishvattanartha gomo jadartho, mohiyasam padarajo visekam, niskinchananam nabrinito javad. Niskinchan sadhu, if you are not going to take bath by the help of those dust particles from the lotus feet of a Paramahansa sadhu, there is no possibility that you can get bhakti. No possibility. And here, we find those list of devotees, they never gone through Vedas, Vedanta, anything. No Pashidaman, even they are not going to worship in a Mahatma. They are not doing any austerity on finances. No brata, bhav, they have taken no austerity finances. Simply by satsanga, satsangyat mam upagataha. Simply by the help of satsanga, they are going to reach me. Follow. They are also doing bhakti. They are also getting prema. They are going to reach me, getting me mean prema bhakti. Bhakti, three types of bhakti I already discussed. You can remember I was discussing in the at the time of Rayaramananda Sangbhat. Sadhan bhakti, bhav bhakti, prem bhakti. Sadhan bhakti already I discussed, you can remember. Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhava sa sadhana vidha nitya siddhyasya bhavasya prakatyam hidi sadhyata. You know. This you already know. Now point is there, that we will have to attain that sambandha vidya prayajan. We will have to that last object, prema, prayajan, prema. If we have any conception about prema, that is also material prema. At all, if we have any conception about prema, well, I know, but that is material prema. Conception of blood and flesh. Conception of blood and flesh, this kind of prema we know. But actual prema, you know the definition. When Baba develops, then after that you can get prema. Follow? When Baba develops to such a pit that it completely softens the mental quantum of the most advanced devotee, and creates a sense of intense minus. My beloved Bhagavan, I love Bhagavan. This way. Prema actually arising from Baba. Two types of prema can be had two way. As a development of Baba Bhakti, or directly as rising from the grace of the Supreme Lord. Both. Now, Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Dr. Prabhupada suggesting, laughing. They Prabhupada laughing, Prabhupada saying, they like to do Rupanuga Bhajan, Raghanuga Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, that Rupanuga Vichar, according to the Vichar of Rupanuga Goswami, Rupanuga Vichar, Sambandha Vidya Prayajan, what do you mean by this? These three things. Sambandha, we know general sense, sambandha means relationship. Avidya means the process, procedure through which we can advance, proceed. And the objective, last goal, that is called prayajan. That we, general sense. But Prabhupada speaking, if you like to become a Rupanuga follower, Baba speaking, try to understand. Don't hear anybody. Try to hear Prabhupada. Try to hear Rupanuga Varayate Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't hear anybody. They can cheat you anytime for personal pratishtha. There is no guarantee. No demigods, no general guru, nothing. Only we will have to depend upon Rupanuga Guru. Who is Rupanuga? Who is not Sahajya? Who is following Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada? Yes. Exactly is the definition. Now, we hear many times from Vidagdha Madhav, or is the definition of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here to give a prema. The procedure is very easy at present. Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, it was too tough. Common people, impossible. But we know from Vidagdha Madhav the identity given by Rupa Goswami Pad. Repeatedly we are hearing and speaking. Anarpita charing chirat karunaya karunaya avatirna kalau samarpayatu unnato jalarasam sabhakti sriyam harihi purata sundara dudikadamba sandivito sada hida gandare spurutva sisachinandana. That we hear many times. That kind of exclusive prema sampatti property was not given any time in the past. Anarpita charing chirat karunaya avatirna kalau. Out of his causeless mercy coming here, appearing. Samarpayatu, why? By samarpayatu munnato ujjararasam. To give which is very, very rare. For Brahma, Sankar, for everybody, I already speaking that day, you can remember. That day I was speaking. This is Radha Pranavandhas Charana Kamala Yoho Kesa Sesadhya Gamya Ja Sadhya Prema Seva Braja Charito Parair Garo Lalyaikalabhya. Many times I told. Which is not available. Is very, very secret and rare thing. It is not a matter of distribution openly. It is not a matter of preaching openly. Only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here to give this kind of prema sampada. In general, through Sankirtan wanted to give, you know, bhakti. But this special thing, you know, praja prema is very rare. Sankirtan yajna, through Sankirtan yajna, Mahaprabhu wanted to give everything. But those who are qualified to receive, you know, Patra Patra Vicharanang at the time of Mahaprabhu, when he came, that he was not thinking about who is qualified, who is not, that was exclusive thing. Patra Patra Vicharanam na kurute. No. This vichar is very exclusive. Now, Prabhupada speaking, if you want to regulate your life, bhajan life, according to the guidance of Rupanuga, Rupa Goswami Pad, if you can come out successful to follow Rupa Goswami Pad properly, if you become Rupanuga, if you are really, if you can become a Rupanuga genuinely, then automatically you can understand all the glories of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. It can get manifest, it can get manifested inside your heart automatically. Jiver supta hidaya prakatit hoibe. It's very rare, but it can automatically flourish inside your heart if you become Rupanuga. But if you can chitter, then no, you can lose your bhajan life, everything. Prabhupada speaking, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nam is Sambandha. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Nam is Sambandha. And Gaur Kipa Krishna Bhakti Avidya. Gaur Kipa Krishna Bhakti Avidya. And Gaur Deo, what Gaur want to give Krishna Prem is Prayajan. Ultimately, Sambandha Avidya Prayajan. This is the. So Prabhupada requesting to everybody, Prabhupada requesting everybody, that's why it is my request to you all that don't try to read any other books. Try to follow Goswami books, Gaur Sundari, which is very Gaur Sundari, what Gaur Sundari wanted to preach. What Gaur Sundari wanted to preach, Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, they are all following this procedure. They are preaching. They are the topmost preacher. Maybe Rupa Goswami is not going to foreign country. Jiva Goswami is not going to Raghunath. But they are the topmost preacher of Gauriya bhajan cult. They are the topmost. They are not going to foreign country. So what? I already told many times before, Baba speaking, to get established in the Acharan and Adarsha idealism and efficacy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, itself, it is the quality of a preacher. What is the main quality of a preacher? Preacher doesn't mean he can speak, you know, very nice, he is a platform speaker, not that. Preacher means, Baba speaking, preacher means, if he is totally established in Gauriya, in Gauranga Mahaprabhu Acharan, efficacy and idealism, he is automatically a preacher. Because his name, everybody can know. Who is going to preach the name of Gaur Kishore Baba automatically? Gaur Kishore Baba never wanted to preach his name. That I am Rupanuga Bhajan, Rupanuga devotee. Never wanted to hide himself all the time. Madhavendra Puripada wanted to hide himself. Follow, always. Ishwar Pradhyaya Madhavendra Puripada, all Sanatana Goswami Vidya, all wanted to hide himself. But Pratishtar Svabhav Hei Jaina Chaye Tar Hoy Vidada Nirmito. It is the nature of genuine Pratishtha. It is the nature of Vaishnavi Pratishtha. It is the nature of Vaishnavi Pratishtha that if the Vaishnav don't want to get it, it is not man-made. It is arranged by Supreme Lord. It is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord automatically going to preach. The devotee like to hide himself. No, I am fallen soul, I am nothing, I have done nothing, I like to hide himself, this is called Dainya. If not Dainya, if humbleness is not there, if somebody is going to criticize the other, then he is not a preacher. Because preacher means to speak Harikatha. Preacher means to speak Harikatha. And the first condition of preaching is Trinada Visanichana. Like mathematics. If he is not himself established in Guru Charan, Guru Parampara, he is not totally established in Gauranga Acharan, he is doing all rubbish. Siddhanta, Acharan, I can show you. We are not going to establish a fault-finding mission. We are not going to establish a fault-finding mission. Simply, we like to detect our shortage. We like to rectify ourselves by the help of Guru Varga, Guru Parampara. If somebody is going to say all rubbish against Guru Varga, we can give fitting answer. This is the advice of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So he is criticizing about our Guru Varga. He is not a preacher, cannot be a preacher. Not possible. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking. Trinada Visanichana Tarva Sreshna Manir Mahadir Kitunya Sa. Preaching can automatically done. Preaching can automatically done. If you are established in Achar Adarsha, you can see it is the arrangement of Bhagavan. Too much attention for preaching and all the time and no Acharan, nothing, it's not good. Anyway, Prabhupada requesting everybody that if you like to understand the preaching procedure of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give, then all the writings of Prabhu Goswami Pad, all in favor of the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So you try to go through the books of written by Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami Pad. They are going to help the preaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings. They are helping. Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to ignore Rupa Goswami Pad, if you want to ignore Rupa Goswami Pad, that going to do something special, then all can bring invite Amangal. Prabhupada speaking, if you want to ignore Rupa Goswami Pad, if you want to ignore Rupa Goswami Pad, what Rupa Goswami Pad told, what he wrote, if you want to ignore him, try to become a big preacher. Rupa Goswami Pad, Prabhupada speaking, if you want to ignore Rupa Goswami Pad, whatever you like to do, by ignoring Rupa Goswami Pad, all can invite Amangal in your life, and those followers, those who are following you, all can bring, they can all can get Amangal and Amangal. No other way. No other way open. Only Amangal and Amangal. So, we are really interested to follow Rupa Goswami Pad. We want to become a follower of Rupa Goswami Pad, but not that way. The way we are following, not that. It is true, honor with Charing Chirat Karunayavatirna Kalu, Samarpayat Unnato Ujjalarasa Savakti Sriyam, Harihip Purata Sundara Dvadikadamba Sandivita, Sada Hidayakanda Spurduva Sachinanda. This is the glorification of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by Rupa Goswami Pad from Vidagdha Madhav. And previous day I was also clarifying this point, because the sloka, second sloka, third sloka I can start, discuss today. That day also I was discussing. So the reason for why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here is very important, we must understand. The reason, and that I already discussed many times, see, Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Baneva Swatva Jaina Bhutta Madhurima Kidrisho Bamadiyaha Shokshan Chasho Madhana Bhavataha Kidrisham Bhatila Beti Lobhat Tad Bhavaddo Samajani Shachi Shachigarva Sindhu Hari Indu. What is the quality of the Pranaya love? What is the glory of the loveful affairs shown by Radharani? Radha Pranaya Mahima. What is the glory of the Pranaya love of Radharani? And I have some excellency, and Radharani going to relish, Radharani going to take the test, and she is going to get absorbed into this kind of, you know, test, madhu, honey, what is available in me? What is that kind of honey? I also like to know. And what kind of feeling Radharani want to get? And why? And how? What kind of, you know, bliss? What kind of transcendental bliss? Excellent, you know, bliss she is feeling. All the three reasons for why Krishna wanted to take birth in the form of Gauranga, molten golden complexion, and stealing the Baba of Radharani, and stealing the body complexion of Krishna. And Radha Krishna Pranaya Mahima, now see, Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti, another slope, our Swarup Gosai writing, Radha Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasmad Ekat Manau Opi Bhubi Pura Dehovadam Gato Tau Chaitanya Akshyam Prakadam Adhuna Tad Dayan Chaikam Aptam Radha Bhavaduti Suvalitam Naomi Krishna Sarupam. Sarugosa writing is the same Krishna coming in this form. And Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Unification and though same, one and single, Adyaganda Tap still going to take two forms, Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasmat. Ekatmanu Opi, they are same Atma, same thing. Opi, but still they, mana, divide, they wanted to divide themselves into two parts. And that unification of that two parts, Radha Govinda, Chaitanya Aksham Prakata Madhuna, with Radha Bhava Subhalitam, that we already know everything. Now the point is that this prema, surely without Raganuga Bhajan, without Rupanuga Bhajan, without Raganuga Bhajan, Vidhi Marge Krishna Prem Paita Nahi Shakti. Vidhi Marge, by Vidhi Marge, that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu write from the beginning. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu right from the beginning of student life, after that, changing, going to show something new, after that, grihastha life, after that, sannyasa, everything, all. Every time Mahaprabhu wanted to show the mode of bhakti, how to develop bhakti, and finally wanted to indicate something, and more finally, after there in Purushottam Dham Nilachal Khetra, there Mahaprabhu wanted to exhibit Radhabha more clearly. Radha Bhav, Manjari Bhav, Sakhi Bhav, different time wanted to show us very clearly. That's why, you know, previous day I was discussing that without Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how it is possible for us to understand. So that day I was discussing prema namad bhutartho savano pathagatah kasyo namnam nahinnah prema namad bhutartah savano pathagatah kasyo namnam mahinnah ko vetta kasyo vrindavan vipino mahamadurishu praveshah ko va janati radham paramaraso chamatkaro madurichu seema Mekos Chaitanya Chandraha Paramakarunaya Sarvam Avishchakaraha. Also, Prabhupadananda Saraswati Bhai also almost same sloka, but I have some speciality here. Here, glorification of Radharani Charan. Prema Lasa Iko Seema Paramas Chamatkara Vaichistha Seema Sandarja Saika Seema Kimapi Navabayo Rupa Lavanna Seema Lila Madurja Seema Nijayana Param Audarjo Vatsallo Seema Sa Radha Soksha Seema Jayati Rutikala Keli Madhurjo Seema. It is the exclusive glorification of Radharani. What is the overflowing love affair? Prema Lasaika Seema, extreme point. Paramas Chamatkar, more excellent, excellent, excellence is there, new diversity. You know, there, Vaichitra Seema, all different kind of diversity, also Radharani is the extreme point. And Sandarjo, what to speak about Sandarjo? Krishna Bhagavan went to be, Krishna Bhagavan is always attracted, Krishna Bhagavan is always attracted by Radharani. Sandarjo Saika Seema, Kimapi Navavayo Rupa Lavanna Seema. What is the age is very teenage age, very attractive age, very, very glamour, very nice. And Lila Madhurjo, time to time, Radharani going to do such different type of behavior and Lila, so that Krishna feeling more and more attraction. Krishna feeling more and more attraction, very casually. You know, Lila Madhurjo Seema, that kind of Lila Madhurjo Seema, you know, beautiful Leela, honey and honey, nectar coming out, is also extreme point. Nijajanapuram, Audarjo Seema, for those Sakhi Manjari, Radharani going to open heart, oh, very, very clearly, Audarjo Seema, more, you know, liberated way. Patsala Seema going to show extreme love affair to them. Sarada Soksha Seema, you know, is also friendship end point. Sarada Soksha Seema Jayati Rutikala Keli Madhurjo Seema. It is also that Radharani is her mood and, you know, all Leela, everything, all mood stolen by Gauranga, all stolen by Gauranga. And now Gauranga Mahaprabhu went to express everything. Without the appearance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, it would not have been possible for us to understand clearly what is Krishna Prema, Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. All people busy with their false ego. false ego, jovanam, dhanasampatti, prabhuttam, avivekta. Ekoikam opi, anarthayo, kimuto yatra chatushtaya. We already want to prove that we are in bhajan. But if we are in bhajan, then this kind of fourth thing, jovanam, I have very bodily power, jovan, very young age. Jovanam dhanasampatti, huge amount of dhanasampatti, I have taken birth, you know, high family, all going to create, develop some false ego inside me. Now, Niti Shastra, principle, only principle. It is not from any Shastra, but a principle, quote. Jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekitaha. You know, prabhuttam means I want to get control over everybody. I want to get control over, I want to become acharya. I like to get control over you and everybody all over the world. But I have no controlling over myself. That is a tragedy. Follow. Most vital point, I have energy, I am youth age, young age, okay, I can do something. That time, like, you know, the two sons of Kuber, Nala Kuber, the young age, they are from high family, they are rich, very rich, all riches. They went to ignore Naraji Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj is respected by everybody, even Bhagavan going to respect. But they wanted, oh, we're useless. They are not going to pay any dandavat and any respect. So it is the nature of young age. Jovanam dhanasampatti, they are having big riches. Prabhuttam, they want to get control over everybody. That is our bhajan, we want to get control over. If you are not in favor of me, I like to throw you. Like political leader. If you are not going to give vote to me, I can cut you. I can throw you. This is the situation. Follow. Jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita. Our consciousness is sub-zero level. Our consciousness is so sub-zero level, we can be compared with animal. Only we know me and mine, nothing else. Prabhuttam avivekita. Avivekita, no consciousness, nothing. You know, what is good, what is bad, what is, you know, I should do, what I should not do. Now, the principal sutra is speaking, jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita. Ekoikam opi anarthayo. One of such four qualities can put me in trouble. Ekoikam opi anarthayo. Can invite Amangal in my life. What to speak about if all those four things are there with me? Who is there in this world? Who is having full power? He can preach all over the world. He have educational qualities, everything. Not one to get any pratishtha. Can you show me one and a single such personality? So, jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekita ekoikam opi anarthayo kimuto yatra chatushtaya. Nobody can get rid of false ego. That is the main. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu whole life, how to proceed, how to do bhajan gradually, all Mahaprabhu wanted to show us in each and every time Mahaprabhu to establish the dignity of Guru Vaishnava. We want to ignore the dignity of Guru Vaishnava, we want to insult Guru Vaishnava. But Mahaprabhu is saying, I cannot bear if somebody is going to ignore, somebody is going to insult, somebody is going to ignore the glories of Guru Vaishnava. I cannot bear. If somebody is going to violate their dignity, I can never bear them. Many times Mahaprabhu in his whole life went to show this way. Now, Bhagavan is full of ananda, anandam brahmo. I already discussed yesterday, I was discussing yesterday, Akshatiti Aditi in the new place, inauguration ceremony, that anandamai, Bhagavan is anandamai brahmo. Okay. But still, though Bhagavan is anandamai, still Ladini, the extract, the genuine extract of that Ladini Shakti, Bhakti, which is coming from devotees, can give more and more excellent, more and more thrill Bhagavan can feel. More and more thrill Bhagavan can feel if devotee is going to show bhakti to Bhagavan. Follow my teaching. Bhagavan itself saturated, there is no discontent, dissatisfaction, saturation is there. Bhagavan is Anandamay, I already told from Vedanta Sutta, Anandam Brahma, but still, Ladini Shakti Shah, the extract, you know, the total gist of Ladini Shakti, Bhakti, which is coming from devotees to touch the lotus feet of Bhagavan, I mean heart, Bhagavan feeling more and more thrill for that. That's why Bhagavan wanted to take decision that I can come in the form of devotees. Be careful, whole Leela of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I mean from Gaur Leela, I mean Navadvip Leela, there Mahaprabhu wanted to express devotee Leela, Bhakta Leela. Don't make confusion. Mahaprabhu when started, you know, showing Bhakti, first of all Mahaprabhu wanted to, you try to understand from the Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is final, which is coming from the mouth of any genuine source. Same the teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If coming from the mouth of Prabhupada or Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we are very happy, because we know there cannot be any distortion of the teachings. Same intact. That is the utility of parampara. If parampara not going to give me the same teachings, if parampara not going to give me the scope to get the same teachings which were spoken at the time of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, what is the utility of parampara? You foolish, you don't understand. What is the utility of parampara? The utility of parampara is that I can give same bhakti, same teachings without any distortion, deviation. That is the utility of parampara. If parampara, some infiltration, some problem entering, contamination, then parampara breakage there. You cannot get the power of that parampara. Morning time, Krishna Yita Chaturmukh, Hai Krishna Sevanmukh, every day we will have to go. It is called, it is, Prabhupada wanted to show, through parampara we are going to create the power. If I want to ignore Guru Parampara, want to, you know, preach something new, it is not Guru Parampara. You are already deviated, and those who are following you, they are also going to hell. You are speaking lie, all rubbish, not actually Gauriya philosophy. Not, sometimes speaking something, but contaminated. In that case, your preaching cannot give any good result. Only some chaos and, you know, busyness. So you see, actually, the utility of parampara is intact. We like to get the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. For that reason, you will have to search out the genuine source through which you can connect your source with parampara. Otherwise, you can get derailed, deviated, and you can lose your bhajan, simple bhajan. But to speak about Raganuga bhajan, I am not going to speak up to that far. I am not Sahajiya. Now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you must follow the life, you know, life and percepts of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as was written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In Gaur Leela, in Navadvip Leela, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu all wanted to unveil the mystery of bhajan, general bhajan. First, Mahaprabhu wanted to identify himself as devotee. Mahaprabhu wanted to manifest himself. Mahaprabhu wanted to identify himself as a very poor, poor devotee. I have nothing. He is begging bhakti from Advaita Gosai, touching the lotus feet of Advaita Gosai. Sometimes going to request Sivas, you give me Sivas Pandit, you know. You bless me so that I can get bhakti. Sivas speaking, well, someday you can get. Now, Mahaprabhu, after educational lila, chhatra lila, student lila. Mahaprabhu wanted to carry the water pot and clothes, wet clothes of Sivas and all devotees. He started swaying the mood of bhakti. We cannot ignore that. And if we ignore all the previous lila of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, only want to concentrate on Nilachal, Raganuga Bhakti, Rupanuga, is not good. I have to follow all lilas. Follow. What Mahaprabhu wanted to show, that I have nothing, I am poor, please give me bhakti. This way Mahaprabhu started his devotional life. Bhagavan is devotional life, Bhagavan is himself Bhagavan. It is showing us. This way Bhagavan wanted to take, one day Bhagavan wanted to come in the form of devotees, general devotees, first, in the first phase of his lila, Mahaprabhu. Bhaktabhav, in Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj's writing, Bhaktabhav is not a matter of joke. Bhaktabhav is not a matter of joke. Yeah, Bhaktabhav is general law, what is this? No. Bhagavan actually, you know, Bhagavan though full of, you know, enjoyment, still it is the nature of Bhagavan to get new devotees and exchange love affair with them. It is the nature of Bhagavan what to do. It is one kind of game. Why Bhagavan playing and why small boys playing? What can be the reason? In my boyhood, childhood I used to play whole day, 8 hours. Whole day, father beating. What? Are what you are going to get? One penny you are getting? I don't like to understand what is penny. Eh? If I am not getting enjoyment, why I am going to give energy, so much energy for playing? So what is the benefit? And benefit I don't know. Boys they are playing without any profit and loss account. They are playing. Krishna used to play in Brajadham. Gauranga Mahaprabhu also used to play. What is the reason? What interest? And always you are like businessman thinking about interest. Now Bhagavan speaking to Uddhava in 10th canto, 16th chapter, 19th slok. Tam tu bhagavatamo. Nah, sorry. Tam tu bhagavateshu aham. Tam tu bhagavateshu aham. Among all Bhagavat Bhakta Mahabhagavat, he Uddhava, among all Mahabhagavat devotees, my identification is you. My identification is you. Uddhava, you. So, tam tu bhagavateshu aham. And now try to understand Bhagavan going to identify himself this way, and that Uddhava finally after getting a lesson, proper lesson from those Brajavasis and Brajagopis, it was his only prayer that Bande Nanda Bhajastrinam Padorenu Mavikhnasaha Jasam, you know, follow. Bande Nanda Brajastinam Padurenu Mavikanasa Jasam Harikatha Digitam Punati Bhavanatrayam. Bhagavan speaking, I am Uddhava. Among devotees, Mahabhagavat, I am you. And that Uddhava going to pray. It is open prayer, crying and speaking. I like to glorify the lotus feet of those Brajagopikas. I like to get one dust particle from their lotus feet. So lucky there. Jasam Harikathat Gitam. They are crying and speaking Harikatha, all Brajagopikas. This Harikatha can purify whole world. My slogan, my preaching like political leader, my slogan, my preaching like political leader cannot bring any change in the there is a condition. But Brajagopis, And those are Guru Vargas, those who are under the guidance of Prabhupada Bhakti Thakur, if they are going to speak one word, Harikatha, that can change the heart of all bonded souls. Follow. Whereas my preaching like political leader cannot change their heart, the heart of whole, they cannot change even one Jivatma, I cannot change them, because it's not Harikatha. If Harikatha, then heart can change, I can feel submission, I can gradually go and feel everything, only some personal issues, personal interests cannot disturb me, not possible. So, Bande Nanda Brajasthinam, this is the prayer of Uddhavji Maharaj unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. I like to get. So, also I was discussing that it is also still today it is not possible for Lakshmi Devi. It is also not possible for Lakshmi Devi, Lakshmi. Kashyanu bhava ashyona deva vidmahe. Tavangri renu sparshadikara jadvanchaya srir lalanacharattapa vihayu kamanu suchirandhita prataha. Those wives of Kaliyo speaking, Bhagavan, what kind of great luck is there with Kaliyo, our husband? That kind of dust particle, I mean the service of that lotus feet is not possible for Lakshmi, not available for Lakshmi still today, after a long time of astuti and pronounces, still today. Now we wonder how it is possible for Kaliyo that you are going to give, you know, your dust particle on the lotus feet, on the head of Kaliyo. And also you are dancing. This way I was discussing. So now by now you understand the gravity of bhakti in general and specially as a Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, you understand. And also, I like to remind you, what Mahaprabhu want to show us, speak us, that is very important. What Sanatana Goswami wanted to establish in Bihat Bhagavatamrita, Vidhi Marge Krishna Prem Paita Nai Shakti. It is sure, 100%. If you go on following Vidhi Marg whole life, and then it is not possible for you to get Krishna Prema. But that doesn't mean you can ignore Vidhimarg and jump into fire, not into Rupanuga Bhajan. It's one kind of fire, it can burn you up. So, the third slok, Sanatana Goswami writing, Sa Daita Nija Bhavam Jo Vibhavyo. Very carefully you hear. If you have any general conception about Sanskrit, you can understand. Sva Daito nijo bhavam jo vibhavyo svabhavat su madhuram avatirno bhakto rupena lobhat jayati kanaka dhama krishna chaitanya nama hari riha jati vesaha sri chait si sachi sunu resha mean, if somebody is standing in front of you, mentally or physically, because maybe you are in Baba, physically not there. So both, you can apply this point. Chaitanya Sunu Resha. Resha means, who is standing in front of me, to point out him. Who is standing in front of him, who is standing in front of me, to point out that personality, we are using Esha. This word in Sanskrit. So, si sachi sunu resha. This sachi sunu, this sachinandan, he is Hari, Hari Riha, he is Hari himself, and has taken the base of Brahman, Jati Vesaha. He is Jayati Kanaka Dhamma, he is a golden complexion body, as one kind of, you know, effulgence coming, golden effulgence. You know, Krishna Chaitanya Nama, his name is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who out of his, you know, mood, out of personal desire to distribute prema, So daito nijabhavam. Hey, you wanted to nijabhav. With Radhabhav coming, nijabhav means what is there, what is the excellence there in Krishna to get the test. Radharani can test, Krishna cannot test. For that reason, Krishna must come in the form of Radha. If Krishna tried to understand what is the excellence Radha feeling, what is the enjoyment Radha getting, is not possible. Because it is, you know, object of bhakti. Follow. All pervading Supreme Lord, you know, predominating absolute, and Radharani is predominated absolute. Not that Radharani is separate and Krishna is separate. Not that. You can think that way because you are habituated. That's why Prabhupada speaking, thousands of birth you will have to wait to understand the glories of who is Radharani. Prabhupada speaking, we can publish very shortly. You can understand. Swa dvaita nijabhavam. And on nijabhav, what is the excellency devotees they are feeling for me? Swa dvaita nijabhavam. Jo vibhavbo svabhavat. Swa bhavat. Out of greed, wanted to, you know, he is very interested. Greed, one kind of greed. Su madhuram avatirno. Very sweet incarnation. Su madhuro avatirno bhakto rupena lobhat. Lobhat means out of greed. Out of greed, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here in the form of devotees. He wanted to get the taste of that devotional mood, one a devotee always enjoying. That's the thing Mahaprabhu wanted to give as a gift. That is a great gift. Honor Pita Charing Chirato, ever, never, evergreen donation, a gift which was never given before. Now, our Pujyapad Granthakar, I mean Sanatana Gosai Bhad, going to feel his own weakness. That is, try to understand, repeatedly I am speaking same thing, that the humble attitude is the main property. If I have no humble attitude, then preaching can never be done by me. Preaching can never be done by me. It's not, but people can shout and people can give slogan. What it concerns to us? Pujyabad, our respectable Sanatana Gosai Bhad, always feeling his own weakness. Pujyabad, respectable Sanatana Gosami, always feeling his weakness. Oh, I am nothing, I am a fallen soul. I have no capacity to, you know, write this. So to get the mercy and kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he first writing this sloka out of his humble attitude, humbler than the blade of grass. Tvam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Bande Jagat Gurum Jasyanukampaya Swapi Mahadvim Santarita Sukham. Similar sloka I was discussing previous day, you can remember. It is written by Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is speaking Purisher Kito Hite Muishe Logishto. Jagai Madai Hite Muishe Pabishto Purisher Kito Hite Muishe Logishto. What kind of humbleness? Krishnadas Kaviraj is Goswami, the topmost preacher. Rupa Goswami Bhad is the topmost preacher. Follow, Sanatana Goswami is the topmost preacher. Raghunath is the topmost Jiva Goswami Bhad, because they are humble. I am not a preacher. Prabhupada preacher. Bhakti Vinod Thakur preacher. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. is a preacher, they have the humble attitude. To speak strictly, to speak heavy siddhanta is not, to speak heavy siddhanta is not the, you know, not the evidence that Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Keshav Goswami Maharaj is lacking, Keshav Goswami Maharaj is lacking sthinadapi, not that. Speaking heavily siddhanta vichar, that doesn't mean that there is a shortage of trinadavi bhav. Rather, I would say trinadavi bhav, without trinadavi bhav, any kind of preaching is zero. Any kind of preaching is almost zero. Only money, position, canvassing can be, it is one kind of canvassing. Canvassing. Preaching can change the whole world. Devotional practice can be there, not drama. So, our worshipable writer, Sanatana Goswami, writing, Tam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Bande Jagat Gurum Jasyanu Kampaya Swapi Mahadhim Santareta Sukham. Similar slok, Krishna Das Kavidas Goswami writing in Chaitanya Chaitanya, Sri Chaitanya Prabham Bande, Sri Chaitanya Prabham Bande, Balayo Pijadano Grahat, Tarena Namato Graham, Bapto Siddhanta Sagaram. Same. Even a small child can cross over the material akash, over the ocean of Siddhanta, which is full of shark and crocodile and octopus. Ocean is full of octopus, but this kind of octopus and shark I am comparing with wrong siddhanta vichar. From different corner of the spiritual, you know, world, they are making all wrong siddhanta vichar, sectarian attitude. They want to establish this as siddhanta. Even a small baby, small boy, can cross over the ocean of siddhanta sagaram, provided he is going to get the full kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The ocean is full of different kind of wrong siddhanta and fighting going on among sadhus, among pandits, they are fighting among themselves. Jat sakta yo badataam baditaam bhai vivada sangvada bhubo bhavanti kurvanti chaisam muhuratma mohum tasmai namananta gunayo bhumne. By the magic spell of the Supreme Lord, those who are in Maya, they are feeling more and more Maya, they are fighting among themselves, mutual fighting cannot give us success. Even we are not ready to identify the real source of Arigata. Politician, we are just like politician, spiritual life totally corrupted. It has gone deep into the root cause. So we can never get bhakti, contaminated. Even today, if we are going to get genuine Harikatha, still we can make politics to stop that Harikatha. We can misguide people so that they cannot hear, they cannot have the chance to go through that case of pure Harikatha. That is our mood. Beastly conception, beastly. We are having beastly conception. Like Krishna Das Kavidas Goswami speaking out of humble mood, but if this sloka is applicable to me, then I am not going to express humbleness. It is genuinely. Poishunno brono prito. Vaigunno. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami writing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Vaigunno kito kalito. I have no good quality. All like bookworm. Bookworm going to eat up the whole book. Even you cannot read the text there. For very dangerous condition. So, vaigunno kito kalito, all different kind of bad qualities there inside me, going to eat up the vital of my real self. Vaigunno kito kalito, paishunno brono prito. I have all different kind of beastly conception. I have all different kind of beastly conception, poisonous. I like to kill pure devotees. I like to throw your devotees. I like to avoid pure devotees. I cannot allow them to speak in my sabha. If I find that Prabhupada is influential, then we cannot allow Prabhupada to speak Harikatha. That is the politics. So better you can get busy with politics. It is very good for you. Don't get busy with Harivajan. It's impossible. So Vaigunno Kito Galito Poishunno Brono Prito Dainar Nava Nimagna Hamsi Chaitanya Vaidyamasrava. If you at all going to get bhakti, nectar, then how and when you can get the chance to criticize people? If bhakti is real genuine property, try to understand. It is common sense. It is common sense, very common sense. If I am going to get bhakti from Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then I have no scope to chase a pure devotee. Guru Bharga, I cannot chase them. You know, bhakti can give me nectarian feeling. I can feel nectar inside my heart. I can get saturation. So I have no scope to speak about, criticize about our Guru Bharga. But if I can speak heavily about Siddhanta, wrong Siddhanta, that is not the evidence that I am going to lack Trinadapi, not that. So, Kishnudas Kaviraj Goswami is going to express this kind of humble mood, and our Sanatana Goswami also going to express humble mood that way, how I can, you know, how it is possible, because I have no, you know, I have no capacity, no quality I have, how I can, you know, this way. They are going to pray unto the lotus feet of, you know, Sanatana Goswami, requesting unto the lotus, you know, expressing his humble attitude. Marjada langhan mai shaita na paro. Mahaprabhu speaking in Chaitanya Chaitamita, you can find Marjada langhan mai shaita na paro. I cannot bear if somebody is going to insult, going to break the dignity of some Vaishnava. Marjada langhan mai shaita na paro. Mahaprabhu speaking, if somebody is going to, you know, give proper respect and honor to God brothers and, you know, those who are genuine devotees, Guru Bharga, then Mahaprabhu speaking, I become very happy. Marjada rukhile tushto hai mormon. I become very happy. Somebody going to protect the dignity of Guru Vaishnava. Criticism is not solution. I cannot speak that I am a big pressure. I cannot speak that way. If I am going to speak that way, surely, if I am going to speak that way, then surely I am not a preacher. If I am going to speak that way, then surely I am not a preacher. I am not a preacher. Be careful. Always this Siddhanta Vichara you should keep in mind. Na chaitanyat krishnat jagati paratatta paramya. Sanatana Gosai requesting, I am going to pray unto lotus feet of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Bande Jagadguru. His Jagadguru, Krishnam Bande Jagadguru. By his jasyanukampaya, by his causeless mercy, one dog, swa opi mahadhim santaret sukham. One dog can cross over a big ocean. Try to understand. So Sanatana Goswami want to prove that my condition is much more, you know, dangerous than a dog. Even a dog, if going to get the kripa of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, even that kind of kripa I am not going to get. There is a humble attitude. So by this humble attitude, we can guess, we can understand that surely he is successful in writing the books. There is no possibility he can fail you. This way actually, we are going to Sanatana Goswami path, going to glorify the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to get the power to write this kind of a very important book. Previously, at Varanasi, when Sanatan Goswami, when Mahaprabhu giving order to Sanatan, you'll have to write this and this book, you know, Vaishnava Siddhi, etc. Then Sanatan Goswami, out of humble attitude, going to pray, Prabhu, it is quite impossible for me. If you can put your lotus feet on my head and promise that time to time, according to your necessity, according to your necessary, if you can bless me, I can do all seva as you like. But if you are not going to give kipa, it's impossible. So please, you put your lotus feet on my head and bless me from heart, that whenever you can desire to get some seva done by me, I can do it very easily. It is a request. Now in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the same thing, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, that that kind of excellent Radha Prema. Radha is a predominated absolute. So Radharani is Ishwar, Supreme Lord, Supreme Lady. You know, Sei Prema Radhika Paramasray. Radharani is the only shelter. If anybody like to get, he will have to wait, she will have to wait, he will have to wait and get kipa from Radharani. Sei Premar Sri Radhika Pramam Param Asray. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing. That kind of excellent Prema, Radha Prema, Krishna Prema. Radharani is the sole, you know, merchant, you know, sole agent. Sei Premar Sri Radhika Param Asray. Sei Premar Ami Hui Kebal Vishoy. Krishna going to express his mood. I like to get the taste of that kind of love what Radharani is getting from me. But Sei Premar Radhika Paramasa is the absolute shelter of that Radha Prema, Krishna Prema. And I am the object. Predominating absolute, I am the source of that prema. But what kind of prema excellency Radharani getting? I like to get it. Bishoy jatiya suk amar ashrad ama hoite koti gun asrayer allad. I am getting enjoyment, but the asray, the absolute source of that, you know, prema, Radharani going to soak prema, she is enjoying crores of multiplied my enjoyment. Multiplied by crores of, you know, that enjoyment. She is getting. What is that? What is that excellence she like to get? So that's why Sei Radha Bhav Loya Chaitanya Avatar, that Radha Bhava stolen by Chaitanya Krishna and gaudy body complexion coming in the form of Chaitanya Avatar, golden complexion, and Jugo Dharma, divine dispensation. Divine dispensation nam sankirtan, its Juga Dharma nam prem koilo prachar, is naturally a secret reason I already discussed. Sri Chaitanya Gosai Brajendo Kumar, he is Brajendo Nandan Rasamoy Murti Krishna Sakhat Singar, he is Sakhat Singar Vigraho. Follow Rasaraj. Is Rasamoy, Bigva Krishna, Rasaraj, and Mahabhav Radharani. But in Krishna, Rasaraj, Mahabhav, both there. Say Ras, that kind of Ras, to get the enjoyment, to get the taste. You know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming in the womb of Sachi Devi, Sachi Mata, Sachi Nandan Gaur Hari Ki Jai Ho. And as in general course, in general, koilo sab raset prachar, wanted to distribute, wanted to speak about the secrecy of Brajarasa, that was very secret. And men, he wanted to distribute this, you know, Manjari Prema, Radha Prema, everything. Now we like to enter into The fourth number sloka is very important sloka. Jayati Mathura Devi Sreshta Purishu Manorama Paramodaita Kansa Ratir Janisthiti Ranjita Durito Haranat Mukter Bhakteropi Pratipadanat Jagati Mahata Tat Tat Kriya Kathastu Vidurata. Sanatana Gosai writing this book in Mathura Vrindavan. Mathura. Mathura in general, inside the core of Mathura, Mandal, there is Vrindavan. So, first going to glorify Mathura Mandal, Mathura Dham. Sanatana Gosai writing, Jayati Mathura Devi. Mathura is the topmost of all Dhamma. But actually, Navadvipa Dham is topmost. But still, Mahaprabhu coming in the form of preacher and bhakta, so not speaking about himself. But in Shastra, if you go through the writings of Prabhupadananda Saraswati Bhat or other writing, Navadvipa, I forget the name. You can find that kind of excellency and the glories of Dham, like Navadvipa, is rare, impossible. But still, now Sanatana Gosai writing books there in Mathura Dham. So naturally going to speak this way, Jayati Mathura Devi. And also you can remember, in Allahabad, Arail Gram, one village named Arail Gram, in Allahabad, Triveni Sangam, and the confluence of three rivers, Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, three rivers, Brahma Nadi, and that side of river, Jamuna Nadi, there is Arail Gram. There discussion took place. There was nice discourse took place between Rugabad Raghupati Upadhyay, who is the disciple of Madhavendra Puripat, and Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu asking question, which Dhamma among Dhamma, which is the top? Bara, Mathupuri Bara. Among all different Dhamma, Mathura, Madhupuri, topmost. Bara, Madhupuri Bara. After that, Shyam Eva Param Rupam. Shyam Rup is the topmost source of rasa, excellent. Parakiya rasa, so Samo Eva, you know, and Bayo Kaisharakam, Samo Eva Param Rupam. Samrup is topmost. We all Gauriya, we want to worship that teenage Krishna, adolescent Krishna, actually 16 years, you know, Krishna. We want to worship him all the time. So, Samo Eva Param Rupam, Bayo Kaisharakam Dhyam, Kishore, adolescent age, we worship, follow. And Adya Eva Pararsaha, Adya Eva Prime Ras, which is the vital secret Ras, you know, is the topmost Ras, Adya Eva Pararsaha. Adya Eva Pararsaha. So now, Sanatana Goswami is going to write this book, so naturally he is going to glorify the Dhamma. So according to Mathura Mahato, my Guru Padma Srila Paramahansa Bhakti Puri, he also, you know, wanted to show to public. He also already published one book, Mathura Mahato. Tusi Mahato, Mathura Mahato, all he published. Jayati Mathura Devi Sreshta. Mathura Devi is topmost. Purishu Manorama. Among all different Dhammas, Mathura Devi, Mathura Puri is topmost Manorama. So beautiful. Paramadvaita. Krishna liked that Dhamma Mathura very much. Jini, Purushamya Sreshta, Sarvabhishta Purankari can fulfill all the desires of devotees. That is called Mathura Puri. And can can take away mind, consciousness, everything is called Mathura, Mathura. Mathura Puri means going to stir my mind. Mathura. Mathura, manmatham. Mathan, manthan means stirring. Like, you know, churning of yogurt. Churning of yogurt. So, it's going to churn the heart and mind of devotees. So, its name is Mathura. Mathura, Mathu. Follow. Mathura. It's called going to abduct my mind. Going to take away. Going to take over my mind by her own beauty. Kamsari, who is going to kill Kamsa, his name is Kamsari. Not that, you know, Krishna, Kamsari, all beautiful leelas, right from the beginning of Putanabad, everything, right from the beginning, all different kind of leela, you know, Sakatasur, Bhamasur, all everything. You know, follow. Different leelas done in this Mathura Mandal. Not for that. Simply by Bhagavan going to take birth there and staying there. Or to speak about all, what to speak about all excellent leelas. What to speak about all excellent leelas. I am not going to count it right now. Only by birth and by staying there. Krishna, Jatro Sannit Hari, Mathura, where? Mathura is a place where Hari, Atat Krishna, always stay. So by birth, by discovering this kind of excellent Leela, birth Leela, and Avasthan Bhagavan staying in Mathura itself, going to glorify Mathura Dham, going to express the excellency, what to speak about all countless Leela done there. I am not going to count it right now. Mukti, what to speak about Mukti? Mathura Dham, if somebody going to ask Mukti, if somebody going to get Mukti praying unto Lord Mathura Dham, very easily Mukti can get. And what to speak about Mukti? Even Bhakti. If somebody like to get Bhakti, excellent Bhakti, Mathura Devi can give very easily. That's why she is very famous in the whole world, like Bhakti Devi, Vrinda Devi. She is also famous in the world. Anytime, if somebody going to worship Mathura, going to stay one night in Mathura, going to glorify Mathura, and thinking about the glories of Mathura, surely he or she going to get bhakti, no doubt in it. Specially, Krishna love Mathura Devi very much. Specially, Sri Krishna love Mathura Devi very much. So, with all glories, so anyway, by all glories, Mathura is topmost. We cannot even compare with anybody. Now point is that somebody can put question, Maharaj, how it is possible that so much astuti, pinances and bhajan, dance, so many, which is not possible in other place, but Mathura can give it very easily. We have some doubt in it. But it is our request, don't try to express this kind of doubt, because Mathura is excellent dham. You go through the books, Mathura, I have no time to discuss in details. I can give one or two documents, actually. Actually, Mathura Mahatta, all the glorification of Mathura book, you can go through that book, you can find what is the excellent glories of Mathura Devi. In Varaha Puran, it is written, if somebody going to do some sinful activities, If somebody is going to do some wrong activities, sinful activities, then by going to Tirtha, by going to any pilgrimage Tirtha, then he can erase, you can clean heart. So in Bharavapuran it is written, if somebody is going to do some sinful activities in somewhere, then can go to some pilgrimage to destroy the sinful activity, the effect of that sinful activities. But in Tirtha itself, you are in Tirtha, like Mayapur Dham, anywhere in Tirtha, like Ajodhya Dham or Badrika Ashram, anywhere. It is written in Varaha Purana, if you are going to commit aparad, if you are going to commit aparad and sinful activities there, in Tirtha itself, by doing aparad or by doing some sinful activities in some other places, you can go to Dham and cut your aparad, cut the effect. But if you are doing sinful activities in the Dham itself, like Badrika Ashram, Ajodhya Dham, follow. Tribeni Khetra, then that aparad can come return. Then that kind of sinful activities can come to you like thunderbolt. You can never get excuse. On the contrary, what to speak about excuse? That aparad, that sinful activities can come to you thousands of multiple times heavier than the previous. Follow. Like Vajralep, like a covering of thunderbolt. Like covering of Vajralep, thunderbolt. And you can never cut it. Impossible. You can never cut it. It cannot clean your heart. Impossible. Achal atal hoya thake. Parantu, but if you are going to commit some aparad, I mean sinful activities there in Mathura, then in Mathura Dham itself get destroyed. Such glorification you can find in Mathura Mahatta, Varaha Puran. If you are going to commit some sinful activities there in Mathura Dham, instantly it get destroyed. Surely you are not going to get the effect of that sinful activities. It is written, if you are pious soul or impious soul, Sukriti or Duskriti ho, anybody, it matters little. With contact of this Mathura Dham, immediately that can get destroyed. Mathurapuri is the expansion. Mathurapuri is the expansion of Sandini Shakti Vilas Khetra. Try to understand, Mathurapuri is an expansion of that, not expansion, Sandini Shakti Vilas Khetra. It is the place, it is Sandini Shakti, expansion of Sandini Shakti Vilas Khetra. Somebody can express some doubt for them. That's why previously I requested them not to go through this Harikatha. Because you can express some doubt and get finished. Follow. In Skanda Puran also it is written, there is so many pilgrimage there. In Skanda Puran it is written, though there is so many Tirtha pilgrimage like Kashi, Varanasi, Allahabad, follow so many, Badrika Ashram, Rameswaram, so many Kirtha, Sirangam, so many Puri, Ashankha, countless Puri, Bhagavan out of his causeless mercy, wanted to keep arrangement for bonded soul, anyhow, they can get some chance to develop their consciousness. Not that for infinite period they can stay in hell. Not that. Bhagavan wanted to arrange. Okay, they can go to Bhadrikasam, they can take bath. But if somebody is going to do offense, you know, and you know, sinful activity there in Dhamma, that Dhamma can come back in thousands of time, double effect can get. And not only that, but also it can say that it can stay in the form of a layer like Bajra, thunderball. Never you can erase. So in Skanda Purana also it is written, there can be so many pilgrimage like, you know, Rameswaram, Kasi, Varanasi, here, there, Sankapuri. Still, Mathura is topmost among them. Skanda Purana speaking, though there is so many, you know, pilgrimage can be there, Dhamma, but Mathura Dhamma is topmost of all. That's why if initiation or any kind of reformation, yajna, adi, mrityu, even die, or if any kind of, you know, brato, if you somebody going to do some brato there in Mathura, mrityu going to die in Mathura, you know, upanayan, upanayan means, you know, janma, yate, if you going to take bath in janma, if you're going to take bath in Mathura, if you're in a Brahmin initiation, Upanayan started, then Upanayan Brata, Mrityu even die, and Daho, if somebody is going to burn you in Mathura, four different kind of activities, if done in relation to any Jivatma, can give you moksha. Surely, it is promise, it's commitment. Or any kind of four activities, related, you know, any Jivatma related to these four activities can get moksha. Mathura Dham can get give moksha to them. Padma Purana, it is written there, all different kind of pious, you know, holy place. If you are going to seek some result, by staying there, you can get some mukti. Nothing else. Like Varaha Purana also, I can quote one sloka. Many times I went to Varaha Khetra. Varaha Khetra means where Varahadev disappeared, that Khetra. It is from Kasganj. From Mathura, it is long distance. From Kasganj, it is 20 kilometers. There is one temple of Gosai Maharaj. I've been there, Varahadev temple, Gauriyamath. I went there many times. Follow. It is written in Padma that all different pious in important places, pilgrimage, if you stay, finally you can get mukti. Mukti. But, very simple, but very, very insignificant relation, but very, very simple relation if you can make with Mathura. You know, those who are going to beg mukti, they can also, without asking, can get bhakti. Follow what I say. With insignificant relationship, if you can grow with Mathura, then what to speak about mukti? If you want mukti, automatically you can get Krishna bhakti, Hari bhakti. I know you are going to express some doubt about it, but our Granthaga, Sanatana Goswami, is requesting us not to express any doubt about it. It's very dangerous. That's why I told everybody cannot go through this book. They have no right. With full belief, Astha, full of belief, Shraddha, they should hear. Why not you cannot believe? Our Shastra going to speak, Sanatana Goswami speaking, I mean the meaning of the theme of this sloka, what I read, that Jayati Mathura Devi Sreshta Purisho Manorama Paramadaita Kansarer जनी स्थिति रंजिता दुरीतो हरनाद मुक्तेर भक्तेरोपी प्रतिपादनात् जगती महता तत्तत् क्रिया कथास्तु विदुरता। Excellency of this sloka is that Mathura Dham is really so excellent. It is not the exaggerated form. Don't think it is something exaggerated report. Never try to think it is an exaggerated report of that Shastra. Not that. It is itself this kind of glory is there. Then now our Tikaka, speaking, Sanatana Goswami writing commentary also. They are speaking, why man you are going to express doubt? Why you cannot understand this kind of excellent influence is there already with that Dham? Achinta Shakti, inconceivable. Like Achinta Vedavat Tattva, we discussing about Jiva Tattva, Achinta Vedavat Tattva. Achinta Vedavat Tattva, ordinary, those who are hearing Harikatha, they think only this, that Achinta Vedavat Tattva mean, Achinta mean, it is, we cannot think it out of your conception. Follow what I say, try to understand this meaning. Achinto, inconceivable, out of our imagination, we can reach up to this meaning. If somebody asking is the meaning, then I can reach up to this meaning. Inconceivable, impossible to think, that much meaning I can. But Achinto doesn't mean that only this meaning. There is another meaning. Achinto means that there is another ground. There is another ground which is loveful ground. There is another ground. General ground, we can think that way, that is inconceivable. But there is another ground, is unknown to us. That is called loveful ground of prema. There is a loveful ground of prema, where impossible also possible. Where is impossible also possible, that is Achinta. So this way, if you think, that is called complete conception of this Achinta Vedavata. So why not you think, Sanatana Goswami is speaking, why not you can understand this kind of excellent, inconceivable Achinta power is there, inherited there in Mathura Dham. That if there is some insignificant relation with Mathura Dham, then immediately the Dham can express bhakti and bhakti related so many things. Why not you can believe that kind of excellent influence is there inherited in this Dham given by Bhagavan? That even a very slightest, contact with Mathura Dham, very insignificant relationship with Mathura Dham, immediately can give me bhakti, and bhakti related Bhagavan can manifest. Can give bhakti, and bhakti related object Bhagavan can express. That is the inconceivable, beyond our human comprehension. That kind of power there already inside Mathura Dham. So Mathura is all successful to give bhakti and bhakti related Bhagavan, everything. So we should not express any doubt about it. Now after that, I am speaking in gist, because if I go on discussing in details in 2 years, it cannot come to an end. So I am bound to jump, what to do. Now today not possible to discuss this sloka fully, but still I can touch this sloka, number 5 sloka. Jayati Jayati Bindaranyam Etat Murare Priyatamo Mati Sadhu Swanto Vaikuntha Vasat Ramayati Sa Sadaga Palayan Yatro Gopihi Swarita Madhura Penu Vardayan Premurase Jayati Jayati Vrindaranyam Etat Murare Priyotamam Mati Sadhu Swanto Vaikuntha Vasat Ramayati Sa Sadaga Palayan Yatro Gopihi Sarita Madhura Venu Vardayan Premurase. That Bhagavan Bhaktivasal Bhagavan, in his Sadhuganir Hidaya Kamal, Bhagavan staying in Vaikuntha also, in the heart of devotees also, but this, Mathura Dham is dearmost. Because all the time Bhagavan going to love those Goman coward, as a coward boy going to take care of those cows all the time, taking care, loving, Gop Gopi Samannita, and always playing very, very sweet, fruit all the time. That the place where in Vrindavan doing rasa leela, different kind of rasa, distributing different kind of rasa exchange with Brajavasis, and going to increase the bhava of this, prema bhava of those gopikas, Vrindavan is topmost. We cannot ignore Vrindavan, it's topmost. Jayati, Jayati, Vrindaranyam Etat Murare. Priyatamam mati sadhu swanto vaikuntha vasat ramayati sa sadaga palayan yatra gopihi sarito madhura venu vardayan premurase. So try to understand the glory of that Mathura Dham. Try to understand the glory of that Mathura Dham. And try to understand the sloka. Tomorrow I can discuss. Bahavo matpadam prapta trashto kaya dhava dayuho vrishaparava balirvano mayaschatho vivishanah sugriva hanuman nikcho gajo griddo vanikapataha vyadaha kubja braje goppo yagyo patnah statha pari te nadhita sutigana no pasita mahattamaha abhrata tapta tapaso satsangya atmam upagataha vancha kalpaduru sikhi pasindhi vavacha patitanam pavana bhavishnabhyo namah.